Hi there, this is Adam with Sakari. In this video, we'll walk through how to create a manual messaging campaign in the Sakari system. Campaigns are a great way of being able to save all of your parameters and reuse them numerous times. Let's get started by creating a manual campaign. I'll click Campaigns in the left navigation and click the red Create Campaign button in the top left. This will open up the modal to be able to determine what type of campaign I want to create. In this case, we'll create a manual campaign, and now the Create Campaign dialog box has appeared. To create a manual campaign in Sakari, there are three parameters that have to be completed. The first is selecting the contacts. I'll click the Select Contacts button, and this will display a list of all of my current contacts in the Sakari system. And I have a couple of options to determine who will receive my text message. If I simply did nothing and clicked save, all 92 of my contacts would receive this message. But I want to filter this down. The first option I have to filter it is to use an attribute filter. To add an attribute filter, in the top left, I can select the attribute that I'd like to filter on. And in this case, I want to use the role attribute. This is a custom attribute that I've added to all of my contacts. I can select role, and then I have a choice of either equals, does not equal, or contains. In this case, I'll select equals, and I know that the attribute is mover. I'll add that attribute, and you can see that the list has been filtered down to the 84 contacts that have the attribute of role of a mover. Alternatively, I could also use a tag. I'll remove the attribute filter and add a tag filter. In this case, I'd like to send a text message to just those contacts that have a tag of West. To do that, I can select West as a tag filter, and you can see that the list has been filtered down to the 7 contacts that have a tag of West. This looks good, so I'll click Save. I've now completed the contact filter. You can see that the select contacts is now blue, which means that it's completed. The next step is to determine what message will be sent. I'll click on Design Template. I have a choice of either loading an existing template or creating a new message. In this case, I'll type my new message, which is, "Hi team, the office is going to be closed tomorrow." I'll click Save, and now the design template is also blue. The final step to completing my campaign creation is selecting whether or not I'd like to receive an email report after the message has been sent. I'll click on Reporting, and I have a choice of either no report or sending a report after a delay. I'll select Sending After a Delay, and I can select a delay of my choice in either minutes, hours, or days. In this case, I'll select 5 minutes, and I can select the email address that I'd like to have the email report sent to. I can add multiple email addresses simply by adding a semicolon. This looks good, so I'll click Save. The final step is just to give my campaign a name. In this case, I'll call it the Office Closure SMS. Everything looks good, so I'll click Save. I can execute my campaign immediately by clicking Confirm Now, but I'd like to pause for a moment, so I'll hit Cancel. I'm ready to send my campaign. To send it, I simply need to click the blue execution button to the right. The system will confirm the number of contacts that are going to receive my message with an estimated price, and I can click the send button to execute the campaign. To get a status report, I can expand the campaign, click the blue show report icon, and I can see the messages that have been sent and received. To see each outgoing message, I can click the Outgoing tab and see exactly what was sent to each contact with their name, the phone number, and the message. If I want to see responses, I can click on the Incoming tab and I can see the responses that have come in. In this case, we've set up some default auto responses just to illustrate what the system looks like. I can additionally go to the Conversations page and see more information. I'll click Conversations in the left navigation, and we can see that for each of the 7 contacts that we sent a text message to, an open conversation has been created. When a contact responds, the row will be highlighted in blue. In this case, we can see that Barney has responded. If we want to see the full transcription, we can expand the row and see the original message that we sent, as well as his response. If we'd like to respond on top of that, we can click the blue Send Message button to the right, type our message, and click Send, and in real time create a two-way conversation between you and your customers or employees. Thanks for taking the time to watch this video. I hope you found it helpful. We have lots more videos on how to use the Sakari text messaging system, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button to be notified when we add new content.